Good afternoon and welcome to the Nova Scotia Talent Trust 2021 Special Awards Ceremony. My name is Anne-Marie Woods, aka Amani, and I'll be your host for this wonderful event that features some of Nova Scotia's incredible young artists. Now, before we begin, I want to acknowledge that we are in Mi'kma'ki, the ancestral and unceded territory of the Mi'kmaq people, and this territory is covered by the treaties of peace and friendship. So in the spirit of peace and friendship, let's stay committed to working together.
Without belief, there is nothing. No matter how much talent you have, no matter how much work you put in, no matter how much time, how much effort, how much dedication, no matter how much love. It's just not enough. So, Maggie's parents thank you. Devin's mom thanks you. Rini's family thanks you. Mike's students, Veronique's dancers, Sandra's patrons, our audiences, thank you. And Isaac's community will also thank you for believing. Talent Trust. Believe in the creativity of Nova Scotians.
Hello, everybody. My name is Ross McIntosh, and I am the recipient of the 2021 Kenneth Elloway Award. I'm speaking to you today from Montreal, where I am a student at McGill University's Schulich School of Music. Thank you so much to the Nova Scotia Talent Trust for giving me this award, as well as to the Elloway family for providing the funding. It means a great deal to be given an award with such a great legacy behind it. So again, thank you so much.
Hello, my name is Aiden Vaudrey. I am a level 6 student at the Royal Winnipeg Ballet School. I would like to express my gratitude to Nova Scotia Talent Trust for presenting me with the Janice Merritt Flemming Award. This award is so much more than just financial assistance. It means I have people believing and supporting my dream. Over the years, I have fallen more in love with the art of ballet, and being able to do what I love every day is truly a gift. At this school, I'm given so many amazing opportunities, like being able to work with such amazing dancers, choreographers, and teachers who pass on their expertise to me every day so I can become a professional ballet dancer in the future. I would like to thank you all again for not only supporting me, but other Nova Scotian artists as well. Thank you so much. Best wishes, and I hope to see you all in the future.
Hello, my name is Lala, and I am the 2021 recipient of the Peggy Corpum Musique Royale Legacy Award. It is such an incredible honor to have received this award, and it's especially meaningful to me that we are able to remember and commemorate all of the wonderful contributions that Peggy made to the arts community in Nova Scotia. I'm very grateful to have the support of the Talent Trust over all these years, It's been really incredible being able to study at the Glenn Gould School and continue to grow and develop as a musician and an artist. I wanted to say thank you so much to the Talent Trust, Barbara Butler, and everyone that helped make this happen. I'm forever grateful to you, and I couldn't imagine being where I am without all of your help and support. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Abigail Sinclair, and I'm a soprano from Halifax studying voice performance at the University of Toronto's Faculty of Music. I would like to take this opportunity to extend my sincere thanks to the Nova Scotia Talent Trust for granting me the 2021 Sheila K. Piercy Legacy Award. The support of the Nova Scotia Talent Trust has been incredibly meaningful to me over the past few years and instrumental in providing me with several important opportunities for personal and artistic growth. This award will go towards my continuing studies as I enter my master's degree in voice performance this coming fall. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Gabby Trudell, and I'm this year's recipient of the Robert George Jackson Award. I'd like to start off by saying a huge thank you to everyone at Nova Scotia Talent Trust and to Daphne Cruikshanks, the funder of this incredible award. I'm so honored and thankful. This award is really going to help me pursue my dream of becoming a professional dancer and support my training here at Ryerson University in the performance dance program. This program is really the next step in pursuing my dream. I'd once again like to say a huge thank you to everyone at Nova Scotia Talent Trust for everything they do in supporting local artists. All your work is really appreciated. Thank you so much.
I would like to extend my most sincere thanks to Dr. Burchill and the Nova Scotia Talent Trust for this very, very generous award. Dr. Burchill's donation will help me to continue my studies in organ and composition at the University of King's College and at Dalhousie's Fountain School of Performing Arts. I had the pleasure of speaking with Dr. Burchill at a recital I played in August, and I learned that he was the organ scholar at King's College back when he was studying. I'm the current organ scholar at King's College and the former organ scholar at the Cathedral Church of All Saints, where Dr. Burchill was organist and music director for many, many years. So I feel very honored and especially grateful to know that I have Dr. Burchill's support as I follow in his footsteps. So I thank you again to Dr. Burchill and to the Nova Scotia Talent Trust for this.
Thank you.
Thank you, Ross McIntosh, Aidan Voudray, Lala Lee, Natalie Mitchell, Gabrielle Trudell, and Gabriel O'Brien. As a Talent Trust alumna, I am honored to be your host for today's virtual event. The Talent Trust is a charity that supports Nova Scotians who strive to become established artists in their chosen fields. And as a past recipient of a Talent Trust scholarship, I know firsthand how much a support from this organization can directly benefit your artistic practice and your studies. Now, usually, we would meet together at the Halifax Central Library and applaud loudly for each of the successful artists. And this year, we will still applaud just as loud from our home. So welcome to my home studio. The Talent Trust is grateful that all of you have joined us today for our special virtual award ceremony. Now, please remember, if you are a Facebook user, to tag your friends in the comments, or if you're joining us live on YouTube, then leave a comment in the chat and we will interact with you during the ceremony. Today is all about celebrating and featuring the talent of young Nova Scotian creatives. And over the course of the next hour, our award recipients will share with you some of their work and highlight the many different programs and courses they are engaging in, both within the province and abroad. We would now like to ask His Honor, the Honourable Arthur LeBlanc, Lieutenant Governor of Nova Scotia, to present his greetings.
As the Queen's representative in Nova Scotia and as honorary chair of the Nova Scotia Talent Trust, I am delighted to bring greetings on the occasion of your special awards ceremony. À titre de représentant de la Reine en Nouvelle-Écosse et à titre de président d'honneur du Nova Scotia Talent Trust, je suis ravi de vous transmettre mes salutations à l'occasion de votre cérémonie de remise de prix. We gather today virtually to celebrate and honor the outstanding achievements of Nova Scotia's most promising artist. It brings me great joy to hear that the Nova Scotia Talent Trust has continued to meet its objective and recognizes those artists who have excelled in their disciplines. Over the past 77 years, the Nova Scotia Talent Trust has supported and provided emerging Nova Scotia artists with the opportunities and resources through scholarships to hone their skills and crafts. Through this network of support, artists were able to showcase their talents while adapting to the changing demands over the past 2 years. I am delighted to hear that the Nova Scotia Talent Trust artists have embraced the current reality and, despite reduced in-person and increased virtual studies, their dedication for the arts has not faltered. This year, the Nova Scotia Talent Trust was able to support 55 young pre-professional artists through scholarships totaling $71,000. A tremendous success. 18 special awards are being given out today to deserving artists, including the Lieutenant Governor's Award to the recipient who demonstrates exceptional commitment and potential to becoming an established artist. It is truly remarkable to see the achievements and passion, and it makes me immensely proud to serve as your honorary chair. While Patsy and I are disappointed that we are unable to meet all the recipients in person, the close relationship between Government House and the Nova Scotia Talent Trust continues to grow. Just this past October, we were pleased to host a small concert as part of our Evenings at Government House public event series. Nova Scotia Talent Trust scholarship recipients Ella and Abby Hansen gave a traditional Gaelic music performance that included the fiddle, piano, and step dancing. It was a phenomenal evening for Patsy and me, as well as for those who attended in person and through our live stream. Enfin, je félicite les récipiendaires des bourses et des prix à qui aura hommage aujourd'hui dans le cadre de cette cérémonie. Patsy et moi vous offrons nos meilleurs vœux de succès dans votre carrière et dans la poursuite de vos rêves artistiques. Nous avons hâte d'être témoins de vos réussites futures. Before I conclude, please allow me to thank the Nova Scotia Talent Trust Board of Directors and staff, as well as the Scholarship Selection Committee, for your ongoing commitment to our emerging artists and to the arts. The success of these artists is proof that an investment in our young people today ensures a strong, creative, and vibrant society tomorrow. In closing, let me congratulate the scholarship and award recipients that are being honored today in this special ceremony. Patsy and I offer you our sincere best wishes for a successful career as you pursue your artistic dreams. Look forward to hearing of your success down the road. Thank you. Merci. Wenaliak.
Hi, my name is Minio Charon, and I have been chosen to be the recipient of the Lieutenant Governor's Award established by Mira Freeman. This award is given to someone who they believe shows a lot of passion in their art form and could someday really make it in their, well, for me, dance. Right now I am training at Decidedly Jazz Dance Works in Calgary, Alberta, and so far it has been amazing, and I've learned so much in everything that I've been doing, and I can't wait to see where I'll be able to go next year and where all of this training and education and all of this knowledge will take me in my dance style and in my dance vocabulary and how it will evolve and how I will evolve and change as a dancer and where I'll be going next. So thank you so much, all of you NSTT people, for giving me this award, for choosing me. It means so much. And thank you for your belief in me always. It means so much more than you could ever know. Yeah, thank you. Bye. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Chantel Payne, and I'm the 2021 recipient of the Yi Lee and Marion Quo Award for Instrumentalists. Thank you so much to Talent Trust, and also to Marion Quo and Earl Wadden for believing and supporting us Nova Scotian musicians as we try to live out our dreams. As a classical pianist from Wolfville, I'm currently studying at American University in Washington, D.C., where I'm taking classes in piano lessons, as well as trying to learn more about the American music industry. Not only does your support inspire me to study hard, but it is encouraging me to find ways where I can contribute meaningfully to the art scene back in Nova Scotia and to support the next generation of musicians. Thank you so much again, and congratulations to the other awards recipients.
Hello, my name is Kai Panthier, and I'm honored to be a recipient of the Susan Wood Award. I would like to say a big thank you to the Nova Scotia Talent Trust, who have been incredibly generous in helping me to achieve my goals this year, and to those behind the funding of the Susan Wood Award. I cannot say or stress enough how wonderful it is to know that there are people out there who believe in my work and are willing to support my educational goals. This award will assist me in my pursuit of a fine arts education at Mount Allison University, and will make it possible for me to purchase the supplies necessary to be successful. Once again, I would just like to say a big thank you to the Nova Scotia Talent Trust and to those behind the Susan Wood Award.
Hi everyone, my name is Jacob McDonald, and I want to extend a huge thank you to Nova Scotia Talent Trust for their incredible support to me this year, to be able to go study at the University of Ottawa and do my master's in music and cello performance. And the program has been awesome so far. I'm learning a ton and keeping my professors happy, I hope. And yeah, it's just been a great learning experience. I also want to thank Raymond Simpson and his family for the extra special instrumental award that I wasn't expecting at all. It honestly blew me away, and it made me praise God and gave me motivation to prove myself worthy of your investment in my life. So thank you, thank you, and thank you.
I would like to thank the Nova Scotia Talent Trust for this incredible honor. I am very, very humbled and appreciative that I've been awarded the Sheila McKenzie Award. I am truly grateful to anyone who has made this possible, including the jury who selected me, as well as the people who have graciously and very nobly carried on Sheila McKenzie's memory by funding this award. I'd like to thank everyone again for their support throughout this entire year at Nova Scotia Talent Trust, including the support they gave on my last film. Thanks to this award, I will also be able to reinvest the money into one of my next projects and continuing to develop my artistic journey and my artistic progression. Thank you again to every single one of you. I am very grateful to the Nova Scotia Talent Trust, and I am very appreciative of this honor.
Thank you for your kind greetings, Your Honor. And thank you to Minuet Sharon for your performance, Chantel Peng, Kaya Pantier, Jacob McDonald, and Spencer McKay. Thank you as well. Now please welcome the Chair of the Talent Trust, Joann Fitzgerald.
Thank you, Anne-Marie, and thank Your Honor for your thoughtful greetings. Welcome scholarship recipients, special award recipients, members of the Talent Trust, families, and friends. My name is Joann Fitzgerald, and I'm proud to serve as the Chair of the Board of Directors to the Talent Trust celebrating 77 years. I joined the board nearly 7 years ago. What drew me to the Talent Trust was its unique standing among arts organizations in Canada and the wonderful impact on the arts and artists in Nova Scotia. The Talent Trust not only invests in emerging artists, but also drives home the need to invest in all our artists across the province. I'm proud to continue to lend my business expertise to the Talent Trust to help grow the organization and to support the board and diverse community of Nova Scotian artists. The Talent Trust provides scholarships to emerging artists from all regions and communities of Nova Scotia. These talented individuals represent the very best in emerging artistic excellence in the fields of music, film, theater, circus arts, dance, visual, and literary arts. I extend to you my warmest congratulations. Your dedication and passion to your artistic career was even more visible over the last 2 years. You found ways to study online, self-directed, or with mentors. You converted your living rooms into dance halls, film studios, writing retreats, theater stages, art and dance studios. We know some of you have had to make hard choices. Please know we stand behind you and we encourage you to apply again in 2022. Choosing to follow your dreams and become an artist can be a difficult decision in the best of times. And as the cost of artistic study continues to increase, it's imperative that the Talent Trust keep pace so scholarship amounts effectively support Talent Trust recipients' chosen path of study. This year, we were fortunate to award $71,000 in scholarships, plus an additional $48,500 in special awards. While we're proud of this accomplishment, we want to do more and have a long way to go to fulfill the $230,000 that was requested by our successful applicants. The future vision of the Nova Scotia Talent Trust is to triple our scholarship amounts over the next 3 years. And to do it, we will need your help. We cannot do it alone. If you're able, we ask you to contribute to this amazing organization. Please consider donating to the Talent Trust or contact the Nova Scotia Talent Trust Foundation for legacy giving. Today, we're very fortunate to have some incredible partners and funders who make it possible for the Talent Trust to continue its work and recognize amazing artists like the ones you're learning about today. I'd like to acknowledge the generous support of Arts Nova Scotia, the Nova Scotia Department of Communities, Culture and Heritage, the Nova Scotia Arts Endowment Fund, the Craig Foundation, the Creative Nova Scotia Leadership Council, the RBC Foundation's Emerging Artist Project, our website sponsor Immediacy, the NSTT Foundation, and the CN Halifax Community Board for creating an annual $1,000 scholarship in perpetuity with a grant of $25,000. Thank you. We would also like to acknowledge our award sponsors, the 2011 Canada Games Legacy Fund, RBC Emerging Artist Project, Theatre Nova Scotia, Visual Arts Nova Scotia, Dalhousie Medical Humanities HEALS Program, Barbara Butler with Musique Royale, Janice Flemming, Daphne Cruikshanks, Charlotte Wilson-Hammond, Marion Quinn, Kenneth Elloway's and the Raymond Simpson family, Dr. James Burchill, and the late Sheila Piercy, as well as our individual donors whose names we've included on our website at nstalenttrust.ca. On behalf of the board, I thank you. This year, we acknowledge Nanette Babineau. Music has been her life, and many of you know her through her work as an arts education consultant, musician, adjudicator, clinician, teacher, mentor, and performer. And some of you may even have had violin lessons with her. Nanette Babineau's career has spanned over 5 decades. Her resume is a long list of accomplishments, experiences, and impressive affiliations. What many of you might not know is that Nanette Babineau was a board member for many years and helped shape the Talent Trust. Since stepping down from the Talent Trust, she has been one of our leading donor and supporters. We honor Nanette today by adding her officially back into the Talent Trust family as an honorary lifetime director. Thank you, Nanette. While in 2019, we were able to travel the province to celebrate our 75th anniversary, our plans to continue to do outreach in all of Nova Scotia was cut short again this year due to the pandemic. So we need you to talk about the Talent Trust and bring the message to your communities around the province. We need to ensure emerging artists across Nova Scotia know about this scholarship program and apply in 2022. Over the course of the year, we have kept a close eye on many of our former scholarship recipients and would like to recognize their achievements today. Singer and songwriter Bree Isabel received her first gold record for Good News, recorded with Classified and O Sound. Congratulations to Gavin Fraser for being chosen as the first composer in residence at the Lunenburg Academy of Music Performance. Letitia Fraser's paintings were shown at the Art Gallery of Nova Scotia. Shante Grant's award-winning play, The Bridge, was released as a book in May of this year. Abby Hansen and Ella Hansen were invited to Government House for a concert attended by their honors. Amanda Peters was awarded the 2021 Indigenous Voices Award for Unpublished Prose. Writer and director Breton Hannum and producer Garrett Payon's film, Wildhood, was selected as the opening night gala film for FIN, Atlantic International Film Festival, in September. And Jeff Georgery, artistic director and founder of the Camerata Singers, is celebrating 35 years of bringing choral excellence to Nova Scotia. Congratulations to you all. We encourage any and all former recipients to keep the Talent Trust up to date on your accomplishments and where you are in the world so we can continue to support and celebrate your careers. To the members of the Talent Trust Scholarship Selection Committee, who dedicate many hours to reviewing applications, to the board of directors who help us develop our vision and meet our goals, to our scholarship program coordinator, Jackie Dowling, and executive director, Jacqueline Studert, a warm and huge thank you. It's through your commitment and vital contributions that the Talent Trust is able to support so many Nova Scotian artists in their formative years. And finally, to all our scholarship recipients, though many of you will leave Nova Scotia to pursue your studies and embark on your artistic careers, we encourage you to return home often, virtually and in person, to share your talents with friends and family and with all Nova Scotians, as many of you have done this year. Certainly over the last 2 years, you've shown us how vital the arts are in our lives and for our mental health. We are here today to celebrate your tremendous work and your achievements. I commend you on your dedication and I wish you every success as you continue your artistic development. I'm delighted to introduce the 2021 scholarship recipients. Thank you once again for being with us today. Thank you.
As you can see, things are a little different this year, but they are still just as exciting. And we get to bring the award announcements to you in a new way. With that in mind, it is with great pleasure that I welcome Janissa Browne, Branch Manager at RBC.
Hello, everyone, and thank you for joining us for the Nova Scotia Talent Trust Annual Special Awards Ceremony. While I know we would all rather be enjoying this event in person, the beauty of virtual is that it opens the doors to anyone, anywhere. Besides, introducing tonight's artists to more people is a very good thing, and I'm sure we will be seeing wonderful things from them throughout their careers. So a warm RBC welcome to all of you from wherever it is that you're tuning in from. Events like these are always such a highlight for me in my role as branch manager in Halifax. It's important to me, and it's important to RBC, to invest in the communities where we live and work. Our support of the arts has been a long-standing priority as we recognize the critical role they play in building vibrant communities and strong economies, fostering diversity and inclusion, and encouraging a culture of creativity and innovation. We all recognize the barriers many artists face in gaining the recognition they need to become successful in their practice. The RBC Emergent Artist Project supports artists in the early stages of their careers, helping them bridge the gap from emerging to established through mentorship, training, financial advice, and providing access to a broader audience. That's one of the reasons we continue to support the scholarship and special awards programs with the Nova Scotia Talent Trust, which supports the development of emerging artists in a pursuit of a professional career. I'm so excited to announce the winners for this year's two RBC Emerging Artists Awards. The RBC Emerging Artists Award was established in 2012. This $2,500 award is presented annually to an artist who has completed initial studies and shows exceptional commitment and professional potential as an artist. This year's winner is actor Kevin Monroe from Sydney, studying at the National Theatre School in Montreal. Kevin has been quite active in the local theatre scene and won the 2020 Ruth Goldblum Performing Arts Award through Riverview High School in Cape Breton. Congratulations, Kevin. And new this year, we are thrilled to launch the RBC Emerging BIPOC Artist Award. This new $2,500 award will be presented annually to a Black, Indigenous, or person of color who shows an outstanding commitment and professional potential in the fields of visual arts, film, and music. The inaugural winner this year is visual artist Excel Garay from Halifax, who is studying at NASCAD University. They are an active artist slash curator, cultural worker, and educator who co-founded the BIPOC Collective at NASCAD and was invited as a panelist for the National Inquiry on Anti-Asian Racism, hosted by UBC in June. Congratulations, Excel.
Hello, my name is Kevin Monroe. I'm an actor, singer, musician and playwright from Cape Breton, Nova Scotia, and I'm in my first year of the acting program at the National Theatre School of Canada in Montreal, Quebec. It is my great honor to accept the 2021 RBC Emerging Artist Award. Thank you so much to RBC and to the Nova Scotia Talent Trust for your continuing generosity and support of me as an artist. This extra funding will allow me to continue my studies at the National Theatre School, which in my short time there so far has proved to be a thriving environment full of working professionals and incredibly talented classmates. Thank you so much.
I'd like to say a special thank you to Nova Scotia Talent Trust, the board, jury, and funders for supporting my endeavors as a visual artist and cultural worker. The scholarship and special award are encouraging, especially during difficult times. I can complete my double degree BA in Art History and BFA in Painting smoothly this year. This award will enable me to continue to strive for the development of aesthetics and aesthetical theorizations that allows the formation of chance connections outside of known ways of being or logical protocols. I look forward for the many possibilities ahead. Additionally, I'd like to extend my congratulations to fellow recipients of the scholarship awards and or the special awards. For that, thank you.
Thank you, Janissa Browne and RBC Foundation, for your generous contribution. And a big congratulations to Kevin Monroe and XL Garay. Now, please join in and celebrate these next 2021 Special Award recipients.
I'm happy to introduce to you the 2021 Special Award recipients. The Portia White Award, named after the catalyst for the Nova Scotia Talent Trust, lovingly called our first scholarship recipient, is awarded to someone with exceptional commitment and potential in voice. Portia White was supported by the province from 1944 to 1947 while studying voice in New York, where she embarked on an illustrious career. The award is funded by Dalhousie University's Music and Medicine and Humanities HEALS program. This year's recipient from Halifax is soprano Natalie Mitchell. The Talent Trust and RBC Foundation's partnership dates back to 1944, when the Talent Trust was founded. RBC has supported the Talent Trust scholarship program since 2009 and established its first emerging artists program with the Talent Trust in 2012. This year, RBC's $15,000 donation is divided among three initiatives: $2,500 to the new RBC Emerging BIPOC Artists Award, $2,500 to the existing RBC Emerging Artists Award, and $10,000 to the Talent Trust Scholarship Program. We are thankful for RBC's ongoing generous support. This year, the Nova Scotia Talent Trust and RBC Foundation are collaborating to launch the RBC Emerging BIPOC Artists Award. This new $2,500 special award will be presented annually to a Black, Indigenous, or person of color who shows exceptional commitment and professional potential as an artist. Preference will be given to emerging artists studying in the areas of film, visual arts, and music. This year's first recipient is visual artist XL Garay. The RBC Emerging Artists Award was established in 2012 by the RBC Emerging Artists Project. It is awarded to the recipient who, among all others, has completed initial studies and shows exceptional commitment and professional potential as an artist. This year's recipient from Sydney is actor Kevin Monroe. The Kenneth Elloway Award is awarded to a recipient who shows exceptional commitment and potential in classical, orchestral, conducting or composition, choral music conducting or composition, classical, vocal or instrumental performance. The award is supported by the Elloway family. This year's recipient from Truro is euphonium player Ross McIntosh. The Charlotte Wilson-Hammond Visual Arts of Nova Scotia Award is awarded to a recipient who shows exceptional commitment and potential in the field of visual arts. The award is made possible by Charlotte Wilson-Hammond, longtime Talent Trust board member and Visual Arts Nova Scotia. This year's recipient from Halifax is architecture student Charles Bourne. The Raymond Simpson Award, named in memory of Raymond Simpson, longtime secretary for the board of the Talent Trust, is awarded to a recipient who shows exceptional commitment and potential in music as an instrumentalist. The award is supported by the Simpson family. This year's recipient from Upper Kennetcook is cellist Jacob MacDonald. the Robert George Jackson Award, named after the late Robert Jackson, who loved the arts, was established in 2011 by his wife, Daphne Cruikshanks. It is awarded to a talent trust recipient who shows exceptional commitment and potential in dance. This year's recipient from Timberley is dancer Gabrielle Trudel. The Janice Merritt Flemming Award is awarded to a recipient who shows exceptional commitment and potential in dance. Janice Flemming served on the Talent Trust's board for 23 years while making significant contributions within the dance community. The award is supported by Janice and her family. This year, the award is presented to ballet dancer Aidan Woodroy from Lower Sackville. The Theatre Nova Scotia Award is named after the award's sponsor, and it's awarded to a recipient who shows exceptional commitment and potential in theatre. This year's winner from Hammond's Plains is musical theatre student Ryan McDougall. The Yu Lee and Marion Quo Award is given to a recipient who shows exceptional commitment and potential in music as an instrumentalist. The award is made possible by Marion Quo and Earl Whedon to recognize Marion's father, Yu Lee Quo. This year's winner from Wolfville is pianist Chantal Peng. The Peggy Corkum Music Royale Legacy Award will be awarded if merited to the pianist who, amongst all others, shows the greatest artistic potential and excellence. The award was established to honor the legacy of Peggy Corkum, philanthropist and true lover of the arts. The award was established by Peggy's friend Barbara Butler, family, friends and Musique Royale. This year's recipient from Halifax is pianist Lala Lee. The Susan Wood Award honors the legacy of visual artist Susan Wood. It was established in 2019 through a donation drive by Visual Arts Nova Scotia and her family and friends. The Susan Wood Award will be given to a Talent Trust scholarship recipient who shows exceptional commitment and potential in visual arts in printmaking, painting, or drawing. This year's award recipient is visual artist Kaya Pantier from Halifax. The Sheila McKenzie Award, named after the late Talent Trust board member Sheila McKenzie, is awarded to a recipient that shows exceptional commitment and potential in filmmaking. This year's recipient from Windsor Junction is film director Spencer McKay. The Sheila K. Piercy Legacy Award will be given to a Talent Trust scholarship music recipient who shows exceptional commitment and potential in the field of voice. The award was made possible by a generous bequest that soprano Sheila K. Piercy left to the Talent Trust after her passing in 2019. We are honored to be a part of her legacy. We are happy to announce that soprano Abigail Sinclair from Halifax is the winner. From 1958 to 1961, then music student James Burchill received scholarships from the Talent Trust and established his career as an organist and choral conducting. In 2019, Dr. James Burchill decided to give back to the arts community and generously donated $220,000 in bank bonds to the Nova Scotia Talent Trust Foundation. Dr. James Burchill decided that the investment income would go towards the Dr. James Burchill Award of $8,000 annually. The Dr. James Burchill Award will be awarded, if merited, to an organist, choral or instrumental conductor, or if there is no suitable applicant in either of these fields, to a student of another musical instrument or voice. This year's recipient of the Dr. James Burchill Award is organist Gabriel O'Brien from Halifax. The Lieutenant Governor's Talent Trust Award is awarded to the recipient who, among all others, demonstrates exceptional commitment and potential to become an established artist. It was created over a decade ago with the support of the Honourable Myra A. Freeman, the former Lieutenant Governor, and continued with the term of the Honourable Mayan E. Francis and the Honourable J.J. Grant to this day under the tenure of His Honour, the Honourable Arthur J. LeBlanc. The award was established to recognize the support and encouragement of the Lieutenant Governor, who serves as the Talent Trust's honorary chair. This year's recipient from Halifax is contemporary dancer Minuet Charon.
Now, please join me in welcoming J.P. Deveau, board member of the Halifax Canada Games Legacy Committee.
Good afternoon, and thank you for the opportunity to speak and recognize our award winners today. It gives me great pleasure to represent the Halifax 2011 Canada Games Legacy Committee. It's hard to believe that over 10 years has passed since Halifax and Nova Scotia hosted one of the most memorable Canada Games in history. The Canada Games was a remarkable opportunity to showcase our city and our province to the nation. We are very proud of the legacies that remain and that continue to impact our community. We have many things to remember the success of the Canada Games. The Canada Games Centre, the Halifax Oval, many upgrades to facilities across the province, and over 5,000 trained volunteers, and a community that stands much taller and prouder after hosting such a prestigious event. As soon as the Games were awarded in 2007, our board established a legacy committee to ensure that after the Games had come and gone, there were many more benefits left to Nova Scotians for many years to come. While sport was a core component of our legacy plans, our goal was to engage and inspire as many Nova Scotians as possible in the spirit of the Canada Games movement. It was through this planning, leadership, and determination that we have the opportunity to be with you today. Not only are the Games a celebration of sport, it is also a celebration of our diverse arts and culture. The Legacy Committee for the Canada Games unanimously supported that there should be recognition of our arts and culture. That is why a special legacy fund called the Canada Games Young Artist of Excellence Program has been established. The Canada Games Young Artist of Excellence Program delivers up to 2 annual grants to provide opportunities for emerging artists in Nova Scotia to become better trained and recognized in their respective fields. The Canada Games Young Artist of Excellence Awards are awarded to artists who best exemplify the qualities embraced by the Nova Scotia Talent Trust. That of the utmost commitment, promise, exceptional technique, and the highest achievement of excellence. Someone who demonstrates the passion and drive to become a professional Nova Scotia artist in their field of discipline. We are very proud to partner with the Nova Scotia Talent Trust and wholeheartedly endorse the great work that this important organization does for artists and arts and culture in Nova Scotia. The vision of the Halifax 2011 Canada Games was to inspire a new generation of Canadians to embrace the spirit of the Canada Games. We hope that through the Canada Games Young Artist of Excellence Awards, we can assist and inspire our artists to achieve their goals. Thank you very much.
The 2011 Canada Games Young Artist of Excellence Awards will be awarded to a recipient regardless of age and artistic discipline who best exemplifies the qualities embraced by the Talent Trust. That of the utmost commitment, promise, exceptional technique, talent, and the highest achievement of excellence, and is someone who demonstrates the passion and drive to become a professional Nova Scotia artist in their field. A recipient is only eligible to receive this award once. 2 awards will be given out annually. These 2 awards, valued at $10,000 each, started in December 2013 and will be awarded over a period of 10 years. They are the legacy of the 2011 Canada Games Young Artists of Excellence Program. the first recipient of this year's 2011 Canada Games Young Artist of Excellence Award is from Halifax visual artist Ada Dennell.
I'd like to extend a huge thank you to the sponsors of the 2011 Canada Games Young Artists of Excellence program for honoring me with the 2021 Nova Scotia Talent Trust 2011 Canada Games Young Artists of Excellence Award. Receiving this award will help me not only financially to continue and progress as a young artist, but also stands as a huge vote of confidence from the Nova Scotia Talent Trust Selection Committee. So I would just like to extend a huge thank you to the Nova Scotia Talent Trust for their continued support, both financial and personal, of my artistic practice and education.
Thank you, Ada Dennell. And the second recipient of the 2011 Canada Games Young Artist of Excellence Award is from Glace Bay, studying musical theater, Emily O'Leary. Congratulations to all 2021 award winners and scholarship recipients.
Hi everyone, my name is Emily O'Leary. I'm 22 years old and I am a musician and performer and artist from Glace Bay, Nova Scotia. I am so honored and grateful to be the 2021 recipient of the 2011 Canada Games Young Artist of Excellence Award, graciously given to me by the Nova Scotia Talent Trust Foundation. I'm so lucky to have just started my first semester of grad school in New York City. I am at New York University Steinhardt campus studying musical theater vocal performance, as well as doing a dual degree in vocal pedagogy. That way I can be a teacher and a performer. I literally would not be here if it weren't for the support of the Nova Scotia Talent Trust program, let alone this special award. It means so much to me to know that there are people from back home who want to support and further my career and the arts in general. So thank you so, so much. I can never say it enough for this award. And I cannot wait to see what the next 2 years in New York City holds for me. So thank you.
I'm not freaking out. I'm really okay. I'm totally chill, or I will be someday. Cause I'm so near the top, but there's so many mountains to climb. There are plans to be planned, drills to be drilled, cause this dream that I dreamed is becoming fulfilled. And I plan to enjoy it, but right now I don't have the time. Fade in on Campbell, an average teenager, almost grown. Close up on average grades from the average life she's known. Now zoom in the lens on the rest of her friends as she stays alone, doing the work. Getting it right. Cause I know we'll have to be practically perfect, and I'll go above and beyond and pull through. This I can do. All that I'm asking is one perfect moment in time. I'm 17, there are so many things that I can't control. If I start to freak or feel weak, I focus on just one goal. Turn down the panic, attack this routine like it owns my soul. Turn up the music, so loud that it swallows us all. And then there we are, we burn like a star. We're safe inside the world we know. And suddenly I'm in prep for the climb, and here I go.
Hi there, my name is Ryan MacDougall, and I am the recipient of the 2021 Theatre Nova Scotia Award. First of all, I'd like to welcome you to my room, slash studio, slash classroom, slash the place where I've spent the majority of my past year of education. Doing theatre school online is not fun, and it's not easy, and many times throughout the year I've questioned whether or not I'm in the right place for me right now, and whether or not I'm doing the right thing by trying to do this online theater school business. But getting reassurance from the Talent Trust and from Theater Nova Scotia is the kind of support that I need to know that I'm doing the right thing, and that I am meant to be pursuing this right now, and that I have people supporting me. So I want to say a huge, huge, huge thank you to both the Talent Trust and Theater Nova Scotia. Thank you so much.
Hi there, my name is Charlie Bourne. Welcome to the Dow School of Architecture's exhibition room and to an exhibition I just put on this week. This is a video to thank Charlotte Wilson-Hammond and Visual Arts Nova Scotia for their generous support of the Talent Trust, and to say thanks for the special award that I've been very fortunate to receive this year. The award and the Talent Trust in general really helped me to focus on my studies and to be able to dedicate all of my time to the difficult work of going through an architecture program and to help me become a more accomplished artist and designer. So again, thanks to the Talent Trust and to Charlotte Wilson-Hammond and to Visual Arts Nova Scotia. And congrats to all my fellow special award recipients. Good luck with all your studies and good luck in all your futures.
Hello, my name is Natalie Mitchell, and I'm a soprano from Pictou County, Nova Scotia. I would like to extend my profound gratitude to the Nova Scotia Talent Trust and Dalhousie University's Music in Medicine program for awarding me the 2021 Portia White Award. Portia White's performance career and story was incredibly inspiring to me as a young artist growing up in rural Nova Scotia, where opera wasn't easily appreciated nor accessible. And I am thrilled to continue on this legacy as a young artist currently residing in San Francisco, California. The Nova Scotia Talent Trust has continuously supported me from my time at Western University in my undergraduate studies all the way through to my master's and postgraduate studies at the San Francisco Conservatory of Music. This year, these awards are helping me to continue singing and auditioning for different young artist programs at companies all throughout North America, and also to compete at the Metropolitan Opera Competition at the San Francisco District. Thank you so much for your continuous support and generosity to young artists such as myself.
Emily O'Leary, thank you for your performance. And to Audra Dennell, Rye McDougall, Charles Bourne, and Natalie Mitchell, thank you. Thank you for celebrating the 2021 Talent Trust Scholarship, the Nova Scotia Arts Endowment Fund Scholarship, the CN Halifax Community Board Scholarship recipients, and Special Award recipients. Amazing. And an extra special thanks to His Honor for bringing us greetings and being part of a day that highlights the exceptional talent of these young artists. And of course, my final words of gratitude are extended to all of you, our virtual audience, for being a part of today's ceremonies. And please, if you know of a young creative or artist who is undergoing their studies, let them know about the Talent Trust and the scholarship program. We are nearing the end of our event, so remember to like, subscribe, and to share our 2021 special award ceremony video with your friends, family, or artists and creatives in your life. The arts are truly a vital part of the Nova Scotia landscape, so take good care and see if you can find ways to support the arts in your community. And you never know, maybe one of those young people you see on stage could end up being one of Nova Scotia's rising stars.